New phases underway in David Camm's third murder trial with the start of his defense. Camm's attorneys called their first witnesses today. One got emotional on the stand. The trial is in Lebanon, Indiana, at the Boone County Courthouse. WLKY's Marissa Alter is live from there with a wrap of the testimony from today. How'd it go, Marissa?
Well, Rick, a substantial number of David Camm's friends and family were here in the courtroom as his team began to present evidence. Some of them tearing up as one of Camm's biggest supporters took the stand and recounted the events of September 28, 2000. In the lead up to David Camm's third murder trial, he sat down exclusively with WLKY. Camm says he's innocent and says his alibi proves it.
My first inclination is always to speak of the basketball players. 11 honest, hardworking people. Some pillars in the community, some I knew, some I didn't, who have begged to be heard. And the words mean nothing.
The first player took the stand Tuesday morning. Sam Lockhart is not just an alibi witness, but Camm's uncle, too. He told the jury Camm was playing basketball with him at the time Camm's wife, Kim, and kids, Brad and Jill, were shot to death in the garage of the family's Georgetown home. In court, Lockhart said Camm sat out the second game, but was emphatic Camm never left, acted unusual, or had blood on his shirt. Lockhart broke down on the stand as he recounted later that night, driving as fast as he could to his nephew's home after learning something had happened. He described seeing Kim and Brad's bodies on the garage floor and Camm's reaction. He recounted, "He just screamed this loud, primal, howling scream, and he went down on the asphalt and started kicking."
Now it's our turn to talk, and I'm pretty confident in what we have to say.
The defense also called Robert Stites, a man who testified in the previous two Camm trials for the state. But this time around, prosecutors left him out of their case. 13 years ago, Stites worked for forensic consultant Rod Englert, who the prosecutor's office hired for the case. Stites told the court Englert asked him to take photos of and document the crime scene. Uliana pointed out Stites wasn't sent to Southern Indiana to do bloodstain pattern analysis or crime scene reconstruction, things he wasn't qualified to offer an opinion on. In court, Stites agreed. He had no classes in blood spatter at the time, but still deemed drops of Jill's blood on Camm's shirt blowback from a gunshot. That led to Camm's arrest 3 days after his family's murders. Other experts later said the same. It's what Kim's father bases his belief on, that Camm is guilty.
That's the evidence to me. Again, I know they're going to make it a little cloudy, but you know, let them do what they can do.
And testimony continues here tomorrow morning. Now, Uliana said she expects the defense to go about 3 weeks. However, the prosecution went way longer than prosecutors expected because of all the outside motions and hearings that have to go on outside of the jury's presence. Reporting live in Lebanon, I'm Marissa Alter, WLKY News.
Thank you.